Today, the topic of our discussion is on the helminths. Medically important parasites, you know, it can be divided depending on their morphology or cell structure into two different categories. One of the protozoa and another one is the metazoa. The metazoa are multicellular parasites and they are called usually the helminthic parasites. So these helminthic parasites or metazoa, this can be classified into two important phyla. One is Platyhelminthes and another one is Nemathelminthes. These Platyhelminthes, they are usually called the flat one. Their body looks like flat. That means they are not rounded, rather they are look flat. And the Nemathelminthes, they are the round one, or their body looks like rounded. So our today's main discussion will be on the helminths, Platyhelminthes. This phylum Platyhelminthes again divided into two important classes. These flatworms are divided into two important classes. One is the cystote and another one is trematode. The cystotes are also called the tapeworm. Their body is tape-like and segmented. There are multiple segments in their body and the segments unites to form a long tapeworm. On the other hand, the trematodes are also called flukes, but their body is not tape-like, rather their body is leaf-like and non-segmented. There are no segments. The trematodes are also called the flukes. So there are a number of differences between these two classes. As they are divided into two different classes, they have multiple differences. So let us see what are the differences between cystode and trematode. So first, we have already mentioned that cystodes, are their body is tape-like or segmented. But the trematode body is leaf-like or non-segmented. Both of these classes do not have any body cavity. The internal structures or viscera, they float inside a jelly-like liquid, but there is no body cavity. In case of cystode, there is no digestive tract. That in case of trematode, there is a digestive tract, but that is incomplete. That means the digestive tract is not complete and there is absence of anus. In case of cystode and trematode, both of them are hermaphrodite. That means the single worm or the same worm consists of the male and female sexual organs, and they are capable of fertilizing their own eggs. But in case of trematode, they are also hermaphrodite. All the genus and species are hermaphrodite except the genus Cystosome. They have separate sexes. In case of cystodes, the eggs of the cystodes are not operculated. In case of trematode, the eggs are operculated. The operculated means there is a cover on their eggs, and this is called the cover of a capsule. So this is called the operculated eggs. But except cystosomes, the cystosomes eggs are not operculated. So these are the few differences in between the cystodes and trematodes. But there could be a number of differences, and if you consult through the textbooks, you will find there are a number of differences between these two classes. So we'll learn the examples of these two classes. So let us start discussion about the trematodes. We have told that trematodes are also called flukes, or they are the leaf like worm. So the question will be coming that classified trematodes. The main important one important question from this trematode is the classified trematodes and describe the life cycle, pathogenesis, laboratory diagnosis of Schistosoma hematobium. This is one important question coming in the examination. Usually we do classification by the habitat of the organism or habitat of the worm. That means the worms that resides in different body parts. So number one, the blood flux. That means it implies that the trematodes which resides in the blood. The important example of blood flux is the Schistosoma. Then the liver flux. Liver flux is the importance of chronokinesis. It is the liver flux. Then lung flux. The important example is Paragonimus westermanni. And there is also a intestinal flux. Intestinal flux, the example of is Phascolopsis buschi. Heterophis. So these are the example of different medically important trematodes. There are more examples you will be finding in the in your textbooks. So please remember and memorize the examples of flukes found in the different body cavities. So let us discuss about the life cycle of trematode. So these flukes or trematodes, they use different hosts to complete their life cycle. The definitive host is the vertebrate animal like human, and there may be one or more intermediate host. The adult stage of this tapeworm or these flukes, they resides in the vertebrate host. So human or vertebrate host is the definitive host. The adult stage of the tapeworm lay eggs in the definitive hosts. So the egg pass through the stool or urine. Remember the flux, the eggs can be liberated through urine. And the eggs must come in contact with the fresh water for hatching. The fertilized eggs are eggs containing the larval stage. They hatch out when they come in contact with the fresh water, and the eggs liberated a ciliated larva that is called the Myrasidium. So the first larval stage is called the Myrasidium. This Myrasidium penetrates the first intermediate host, that is a freshwater snail. So if the snails are absent or the first intermediate host is absent in any freshwater or any area, so the life cycle of this worm will be stopped and there will be no multiplication or the completion of life cycle. So the first intermediate host or the snail host is absolutely required for completing the life cycle. The ciliated Myrasidium enters to the freshwater snail and there will be multiplication and development of this Myrasidium, and it will be converted into a fork-tailed Sarcaria. This Sarcaria is the second stage of the larval form. The Sarcaria leaves the snail water, snail, and they are freely swimming into the fresh water. So in case of Schistosomes, this fork-tailed Sarcaria directly penetrate the skin of the vertebrate host or definitive host to enter into the new host and start completing its life cycle. But this Sarcaria may form a cystic form in case of other flukes except Schistosome and may be converted into a Metasarcaria. So this Sarcaria is a freely swimming form and the Metasarcaria is a cystic form. The Sarcaria of the Schistosome is the infective form in case of Schistosome, and they start infection into the vertebral host by directly penetrating the skin of the host. But in case of metasarcaria, this can start infection after ingestion of the raw or uncooked crabs or fish. And in case of these other flukes, they can start infection after ingestion of metasarcaria. So we have seen that there are two form of infective form. One is the freely swimming sarcaria, and another one is cystic metasarcaria. Sarcaria causes infection by directly penetrating the host skin, and the metasarcaria is infecting whenever they are ingested.